I've been thinking about my dress since I was a little girl. It sounds really cliche, but it is true.
That's the shape you really liked.
Yeah, that's a pretty one.
I am here with my sister. I'm here with my mum and my auntie.
Too flouncy.
My auntie is very different. She's got a big, big personality and she's going to be very opinionated.
Hi, pleased to meet you. What's your name?
Juanita. I'm the wonderful Anna Marie.
Hi, pleased to meet you. You must be the bride.
I'm the bride.
Hi, what's your name?
Jordan.
Jordan, well, I'm looking forward to working with you. Any idea of a mood or a theme?
It's a winter wedding.
Oh, lovely.
So if there is a bit of sparkle in there.
Winter Wonderland?
Yeah, I do like fitted. I like mermaid. In my head, I like mermaid. I like backless, which is a bit weird if it's a winter wedding.
Now, whoa, hang on now. Just hold it, have a breath.
I am completely almost open to anything. The dress world is my oyster at the moment.
What do you think?
I absolutely love the big frou-frou type style.
Oh, right,
princess.
Cinderella.
Yes,
Cinderella.
I've been engaged 5 times.
Yeah,
I know.
Hang on, 5 times?
But never been married, so.
Oh, are we going for a 6th?
Don't rule it out.
You know, 5 times engaged, never the bride, that says a lot.
Ladies, with all due respect, let's see what looks fabulous on the bride, because she's going to be the star of the show.
I will try to be calm and collective and polite, but it's not guaranteed.
The man in your life, what does he do?
He is a car salesman at Jaguar in Thames City, Nisha. We've been together 7 years. I met him when I was 15, he was 17. Sounds really cliche as well, but he is my best friend. He has a heart of gold. He's the biggest heart I've ever known. I don't tell him enough sometimes. I'm really, really lucky to have him and I couldn't be happier. So I can't wait to kind of be his wife.
First thing I should ask you, what budget, what sort of price are we talking about?
2,000.
Jordan is open to every style of dress in the shop.
That's quite dramatic.
Yeah.
Darling, this is terribly Swan Lake. Oh my goodness.
But her aunt is very insistent on a princess style gown. So that's a good place to start.
It is pretty. I haven't tried on a princess dress before. It does look nice, I just don't know. So I'm trying one on today just to get it out of my system and to keep my auntie quiet as well, but we'll see.
This has gone with the wind.
Wow.
The bodice is fabulous. It's a great fit. We've got feathers here.
Yeah, it is pretty.
That's a skirt. That's a gone with the wind skirt.
I am feeling like a bit of a wedding cake decoration. Just a bit much.
I don't like it. I like the bodice, but it's the layering effect of it, the way it comes down.
I feel like my shoulders look a bit
a rugby
broad.
Player.
I feel, yeah. A rugby player.
You say she's got wonderful shoulders.
If something has to be said, I'll say it.
But you can be a cow.
I've seen rugby players, you don't look like a rugby player.
It's just not nice when you're standing up there in your dress, wanting your family who love and care about you to say something positive.
Jordan, you ready, darling? Come on. Oh, wow. Well, you wanted slink? You've got slink. Wow, this really is a number.
Oh no.
I haven't got anything nice to say, so my mum always told me not to say anything. I've got nothing.
What don't you like about it?
It comes back to the rugby thing about your thighs now.
Anne-Marie, are you mad? Are you completely insane?
My aunt is being a bit brutal with her comments, being a bit personal about my figure, and it's just making me feel really uncomfortable.
Jordan, I love it. I think it's beautiful.
Her legs look fat in it, I'm sorry, but it does.
They do not.
They do.
It looks amazing on her.
I have to give my honest opinion, and that's it.
I'm not listening to anybody. I think you look fat, but Lindsay's got another dress for you to try, ready? So let's go. Off you go.
Feeling very overwhelmed at this point and really upset.
Can I just say one thing, Jordan? I think you've got an awful lot of patience. And I can see, I hope you're not getting too upset.
No, I'm okay.
I mean, I've never heard. Your aunt says you've got shoulders like a rugby player, and then your hips are like what? I mean, you've got the most divine little figure.
So when I see a bride like Jordan being basically bullied, my heart goes out to her.
We will find the right dress for you, darling. That's my job. That's our job, right?
That's right.
So hang in there.
I am disappointed that my auntie said those comments.
Oh, she's crying now, darling, don't cry.
At this point, I do regret inviting her to come.
I think the very first time a bride comes into a store, it's important who she brings because they're given their influences on you.
It's all about you. right, and Mummy said some very flattering things. Your aunt certainly is in a different camp.
Yeah.
Trust me, we will find the dress for you.
What do you think?
It is nice, it is. If you love the dress, you know, it's your day, not mine.
Quite right, hear, hear.
I am feeling amazing. I feel a lot more confident in it.
You haven't been upset, have you?
Yeah.
Oh, Jordan, please, come on.
No, 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 I've not been rude. You've been a bit brutal.
I upset Jordan. I made her cry.
It's a nice, lovely dress. I'm trying to pick up the pieces.
You've got a lot of digging to do, honey.
It's really pretty. How much is this dress?
1,600.
It's in the price range. It's a beautiful dress. Everything about it, the way it fitted her, very pleased, very happy. Do you feel like it's the night, it's the one?
I think so, I'm just
scared. It's the only one I've seen you come out and be smiley about.
You're scared of this.
Yeah.
You've got to feel, I keep on telling you, you've got to feel.
I do love it, it's my favourite one.
Do I have to ask you this question? Are we going to say yes to the dress?
Yeah.
Yeah!